الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأولين والآخرين سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قال تعالى في القرآن المجيد والفرقان الحميد قل إن كان آباؤكم وأبناؤكم وإخوانكم وأزواجكم وعشيرتكم وأموال اقترفتموها وتجارة تخشون كسادها ومساكن ترضونها أحب إليكم من الله ورسوله وجهاد في سبيله فتربصوا حتى يأتي الله بأمره والله لا يهدي القوم الفاسقين صدق الله العلي العظيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد طب القلوب ودوائها وعافية الأبدان وشفائها ونور الأبصار وضيائها وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين الصلاة والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا سيدي يا حبيب الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا سيدي يا نبي الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا سيدي يا رحمة للعالمين وأحسن منك لم تركت عيني وأجمل منك لم تلد النساء وقد خلقت مبرأ من كل عيب كأنك قد خلقت كما تشاء مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم هو الحبيب الذي ترجى شفاعته لكل هول من الأهوال مقتهم دعا إلى الله فالمستمسكون به فالمستمسكون بحبل غير منقسم فإن من جودك الدنيا وضرتها ومن علومك علم اللوح والقلم فهو الذي تم معناه وصورته ثم اصطفاه حبيبا بارئ النسم بلغ العلا بكماله كشف الدجى بجماله أسنت جميع خصاله صلوا عليه وآله يا صاحب الجمال ويا سيد البشر من وجهك المنير لك النور القمر لا يمكن الفناء كما كان حقه بعد اصطدى بذلطه قصة مختصر سب سے اولى وعلى حمار نبي سب سے بالا وعلى حمار نبي اپنے مولا کا پیارا ہمارا نبی دونوں عالم کا دولہ ہمارا نبی وہ کمال حسن حضور ہے کہ گمان نفس جہاں نہیں یہی بھول خار سے دور ہے یہی شمع ہے کہ دعا نہیں بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم after praising اللہ سبحانہ وتعالی and sending infinite salutations, peace and blessings upon the best of creation. The beloved of Allah Almighty, the coolness to our eyes, the purpose of our life, the reviver of our hearts, the inspirer to our mind, the most honored one, the most praised one, the most revered one, undoubtedly the most beautiful one, none other than Sayyiduna wa Nabiyuna wa Habibuna wa Habibu Rabbina, محمد رسول الله
صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وبارك وسلم.
Allah Ta'ala has blessed each and every one of us who is sat here by granting us the tawfiq of to attend a gathering which is conducted in the praise of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. For no doubt, only those who are chosen by Allah Almighty to remember His beloved Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam are called to the house of Allah Almighty to remember Him. And we should be grateful to Allah Almighty that Allah has chosen us to sit here to remember Sayyidina Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Allah Ta'ala has granted us the dawlat of Iman. Allah Ta'ala has granted us Iman. What does Iman mean? Iman is iqrar bil lisan wa tasdiq bil qalb. Iman is to utter with the tongue, iqrar bil lisani wa tasdiq bil qalbi. And it is to believe in your heart, firm belief in your heart. Allah Ta'ala has granted us Iman. The fundamental and most important pillar of our Iman is the love of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is not just love. What I mean is unconditional love. Unconditional love of the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran commands us to love Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam. Allah Almighty in Surah Tawbah said, قُلْ إِنْ كَانَ آبَاؤُكُمْ وَأَبْنَاؤُكُمْ. And remember when Allah Almighty, whenever He begins a verse with the verb قُلْ, which is فِعْلُ الْأَمَرْ, a verb of command. قُلْ, O my beloved, you tell me. O my beloved, you inform them. إِنْ كَانَ آبَاؤُكُمْ, are your fathers, here mothers included. Yani, are your parents. وَأَبْنَاءُكُمْ, and your awlad and children. وَإِخْوَانُكُمْ, and your brothers and sisters, your siblings, your brethren. وَأَزْوَاجُكُمْ, and your spouses, husbands or wives. وَعَشِيرَتُكُمْ, and your relatives, cousin brothers, cousin sisters. وَأَمْوَالٌ اقْتَرَفْتُمُوهَا, and the money that you have gathered, you have earned. وَتِجَارَةٌ تَخْشَوْنَ كَسَادَهَا, and you know these businesses you set up, tijarat. تَخْشَوْنَ كَسَادَهَا, that you fear may go bankrupt. وَمَسَاكِنُ تَرْضَوْنَهَا, and look, these big houses that you live in, the houses that you live in. Allah Almighty, Habib alayhi salam, is asking this question, أَحَبَّ إِلَيْكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ, are these things more beloved to you than Allah is Rasul? Do you love your parents, your children, your family members, your wife, your cousins or relatives, your friends? Do you love your money, businesses, houses more than Allah is Rasul, and jihad fi sabilihi, and fighting in the way of Allah Almighty? Do you love these things more
Nabi Islam is posing this question to us. Allah Ta'ala is asking us that do you love these eight things more than Allah Ta'ala and His Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam on jihad in His way? Do you love them more or not? You see, Allah Ta'ala is asking us this question. And whoever is sat here, he will only be able to give his own answer. You know who you are, what you do. Our religion, Al-Islam, is a deen al-fitr. It's the purest religion, the best religion. In this ayat of the Quran, Allah Ta'ala is not saying. In this verse of the Quran, Allah Almighty is not saying, don't love your parents. Loving your parents is something natural. You naturally love your parents. Allah Ta'ala isn't saying, don't love your children. Allah Ta'ala isn't saying, don't love your wife. Naturally, when you get married, you will fall in love with your wife. The more time you spend with her, the children that she will give you, you will love them. That is your own flesh and blood. Allah Almighty isn't saying, you love them, don't love them. Allah Almighty is saying, look, love them. And naturally you will have love towards them. And Islam has never stopped us from loving them. But here Allah Ta'ala is saying, what do you love them more than you love Allah and His Rasul? Who do you love more? Do you love your parents more? Do you love Allah and His Rasul more? Do you love your children more or do you love Allah and His Rasul more? Do you love your wife more, your cousins more, your money more, your business, your houses more than you love Allah Ta'ala and His Rasul? Allah Ta'ala is posing this question. Remember, Allah Ta'ala isn't saying don't love them. Allah says, look, love your children, love your family, love your household. Have love for these things, but don't love them more than you love Allah and His Rasul. You should love Allah Ta'ala and His Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam more than everything. Allah Ta'ala mentioned eight things here. Allah Almighty said, parents, children. Allah Almighty said, wives, cousins. Allah Almighty said, siblings, brothers, sisters, that's five. Five personal relationships in your life. Parents, include your grandparents, children, grandchildren, cousins, and the wives you get like you. Five Allah mentioned. Then Allah mentioned three things of the dunya, mal, tijarat, and houses. Materialism, money, and business. Do you love Allah Ta'ala more and His Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam more, or do you love them more? Eight things. Somebody might ask the question that Imam Sahib, Allah Ta'ala mentioned these eight things in the Quran, but Allah Ta'ala did not mention jaan. Perhaps you might love your life more. You can love life more than Allah and His Rasul. You can love your life, your own life, more than Allah and His Rasul, because Allah did say this in the Quran. One day, Hazrat Umar Farooq radiallahu anhu, hadith is mentioned in Sahih Bukhari, was with the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And we were walking with Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam hand in hand. And Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam was with them, and Hazrat Umar Farooq took this opportunity. He said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, I swear by the one who has sent you with the truth. I swear by the one who has sent you with the truth. That I, the one who has sent you with the book, Al-Quran. That I, at this moment in time, love you more than everything. I love you more than my children, my wife, my parents. I love you more than everything, my houses, businesses. Everything that I have, Ya Rasulullah, I love you more than this. Except myself. I love myself more. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, Umar, your iman is not kamil. Umar, your iman is not complete. Then Farooq Azam radiallahu anhu thought straight away. Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I swear by the one who has sent you with the truth. Right now, in my heart, it's a guarantee. I love you more than Allah is. I love you more than I even love my own self. I love Umar. I love you more than I love Umar. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa companion, Hazrat Umar Farooq said, I love you more than I love myself. It was then Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa said, Al-An ya Umar, now Umar, your iman is complete. Your iman will not be complete. Your iman will not be complete until you truly, not fakely, you truly love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more than everything. Allah Ta'ala mentioned those 8 things. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam mentioned this. They mentioned life here. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, another very famous narration we all know. La yu'minu ahadukum hatta akuna ahabba ilayhi min walidihi wa waladihi wa nasi ajma'i. None of you will have complete iman until I am more beloved to him than his parents, his children, وَالنَّاسِ أَجْمَعِينَ. Every single thing Allah has created. Even if friend, you love Allah and Rasul more. If I was to stop here and tap into your minds and your hearts and make you think, because I like to make people think, the beauty of a speaker is not to, I'm not saying that he shouldn't do this. Yes, he should inspire. The speaker should instill love in the heart. He should be able to inspire the crowd. He should be able to awaken the crowd, boost the crowd. But he should also be able to make the crowd think. We live in a world where we don't think too much. We think about the wrong things if we do think. Just for one moment now think. To everything that I've just mentioned about how we should and how much we should love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, ask yourself now, do we really truly love Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam more than we love our children, our parents, our families, our wives, our businesses, money, materialism, mobile phone? Ask yourself this question. I ask myself. And it's sad. I'm not here to lecture at nobody. This is the reality. It is sad, me included, that we say we love. We claim we love. But in this love, there is no value. There is no wazan. There is no weight in this love. It's empty. It's like a balloon. It just flies. If you hold it, it's good. When you let it go, it goes. It's not like a tree. It's not like a mountain. You know, trees and mountains are rooted to the ground. When they are rooted to the ground, it doesn't matter how powerful the storm, the wind, the rain is. They will move side to side, but they won't be uprooted from the ground. Is our love like that? Do we love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more than everything? Sadly, no. Because I swear by Allah, if we love Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more than everything, if Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam meant more to us than everything, then we wouldn't be chasing after this dunya. For Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was never ever attached, was never ever drawn towards this dunya. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was never drawn to this dunya. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَكَيْفَ تَدْعُوا إِلَى الدُّنْيَا دَرُورَةً وَكَيْفَ تَدْعُوا إِلَى الدُّنْيَا دُرُورَةً مَنْ. How can you say that the dunya, how can you say that this dunya drew the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? How can you say that the dunya called the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to him? The dunya called. How can you say Nabi Rasulullah was drawn or attached to the dunya? How can you say this? Why? لَوْلَاهُ لَمْ تُخْرَجِ الدُّنْيَا مِنَ الْعَدَمِ وَكَيْفَ تَدْعُوا إِلَى الدُّنْيَا ضَرُورَةُ مَنْ. How can the ضرورت of this dunya, how can the necessity of this dunya attract the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم to it? Well, if it wasn't for Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam, this dunya wouldn't even be here.
نَرَيْ تَكْبِيرُ اللَّهُ أَكْبَرُ
يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ
الْحَادْرِي
يَا رَيْ
Let me rework everything. You maybe have not understood, the ulama have understood. And maybe those who are reciting this couplet of Imam Musiri's point, they have understood. How can you say that Rasulullah was attached, was inclined towards this world, when this world was created for the Prophet? And if it wasn't for Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, لَمْ تُخْرِجِ الدُّنْيَا مِنَ الْعَدَمِ. Allah Ta'ala would never have taken the dunya out of Adam. Adam means not existence. This world is in existence because of the Prophet
Sallallahu
Alaihi Wasallam. We are in existence because of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. Had Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam not come, then today we would not be here as well. This is why Allah Ta'ala said to Adam alayhi salam, لَوْلَا مُحَمَّدْ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهُ لَمَا خَلَقْتُكَ يَا آدَمُ. If it wasn't for Rasulullah, if it wasn't for him, I would not have even created you, Adam. You wouldn't be here today. You are here, the dunya is here. We are here today because of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahu Akbar. But we love the dunya more than we love Allah and Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Or does Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mean more to us? Or does the dunya and the world mean more to us? If the dunya, if Nabi alayhi salam meant more to us, then we would not leave the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Doesn't matter how difficult it gets, we would never ever leave the sunnah of Rasulullah alayhi wa sallam. We would never leave the way of Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam. What's happened? We've come to this country, we've come to this part of the world. We've seen how much freedom they give you. We've seen how relaxed everything is. How if a woman doesn't wear tight clothes, she's not considered a woman, she's not considered part of society. How a lad who doesn't wear extravagant clothing with big branding, Gucci, Armani, he's not considered part of the boys, he's not part of the West. What, we've come to this dunya and we've fallen in love with this. We've come to this world and we've been attached to it. When in reality, the world was created for us. We wasn't created for the world. We wasn't created for the dunya. We was created to worship Allah Ta'ala. And honor and respect the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and love him. And remember him Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. This is why we were created. We wasn't created. You know why? Only why it's our imams are talking like we all have to become Sufis then. We all have to leave everything, stop working. No, that's a fun. You providing for your family is a fun. You have to put food on the table. That's your duty, responsibility. Remember, what the manhaj, the way of the awliyaullah was. These people were known as the zahidun. They had zuhud. You know what is zuhud? Zuhud is to live in the dunya. You live in the dunya, but the dunya doesn't live inside you. That's a saying that we need to imprint into our minds and hearts. You live in the dunya. I live in the dunya, I walk, I talk, I work, I sleep, I study, I teach, I preach, whatever. But then this dunya, the lighting, the desires, the cars, the mobile, this does not live inside us. We do not have desires for the dunya. What's happened? The love and lust for the dunya. Hubbu dunya, rasu kulli khatir. Hubbu dunya, Imam Ghazali rahmatullah alayhi wa makashifatul qulub said, and narrates this hadith, that hubbu dunya, rasu kulli khatir. That it's the love of the dunya that is the head, it's the beginning towards leading towards sin, when you fall in love with the dunya. Do we love the dunya more or do we love Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more? Look at the companions with one like ala alayhim ajma'in. When you look for example, you always have to look at the best example. And the best examples after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam are the ones who followed his sunnah the most, which are the companions. The Sahaba ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'in. The companions ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'in. They followed the Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam sunnah in every aspect, in every way. They did not miss a single thing. They did not miss a single thing. If Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam walked in a certain manner, the companions copied the manner that Rasulullah alayhi salatu wa salam's blessed walk used to be. If Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam ate in a certain manner, they would eat in a certain manner. Hazrat Anas radiallahu anhu used to love eating tadbur, pumpkin. He used to love it. Man, I thought Kadu is not pumpkin. Kadu is pumpkin, yes? What is it? Okay, what's the word in English?
Tell
it. You should have eaten tell it. Kadu. Ghoul. MashaAllah, I don't subscribe to this. MashaAllah. Hazrat Anas radiallahu anhu used to love eating this. When they asked Hazrat Anas, why do you eat this so much? Why? He said, I was sitting with Rasulullah and they were eating this. Because Nabi salam loved eating it, I love eating it. I only love it because Rasulullah loved it. Now what does Anas have with this? This is love. Hazrat Anas radiallahu anhu seen Hazrat Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. You see, Nabi salatu salam was wearing the blessed sandals. And they were of a certain color, hand. They were of a certain color. They went and they bought the same. That's why. Is it because Rasulullah is wearing them? They wearing them, I'm going to wear them. This is love. Every single thing. As Abdullah bin Umar radiallahu was walking one day with Rasulullah salam, they came across a tree and Nabi salam leaned underneath and walked. When Nabi salatu salam passed away and Hazrat Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu wa students were with him, they were walking past the same tree, the same way, same route. And Hazrat Abdullah ibn Umar went down like this. And his students said, Huzur, why did you lean down? The tree is not low anymore, it's gone higher. He said, it doesn't matter if the tree is gone higher, the Prophet salam walked like this. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did this. Even though the tree has grown, that branch is no longer there. But the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is still there. And this is how Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam did it. This is how I man ahya sunnati faqad ahabbani. The one who revives my sunnah, follows my sunnah, he loves me. We are leading the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If we love Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, then we would never leave the sunnah. Especially in the testing time that we live in. مَنْ تَمَسَّكَ بِسُنَّةِ عِنْدَ فَسَادِ أُمَّةِ فَلَهُ أَجْرُ مِئَةِ شَهِيدٍ أَوْ كَمَا قَالَ. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, whoever holds on to my sunnah at a time when my ummah is in decline, when my ummah is going through fasad and fitna and tests, whoever holds onto my sunnah at that testing time, then Allah Ta'ala will give him the ajr of 100 martyrs. Allah will reward him with the reward of 100 martyrs. Now we are using toothbrushes, yes, it's fine. But the miswak is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa used miswak so much that the Sahaba thought that it would be conferred upon them. They were talking about miswak all the time, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Today we've left the miswak. We've left the miswak and we started using Colgate and Aqua Fresh. all these wisdom toothbrushes. There's no harm. I'm not saying it's wrong. The world we live in, they're fine. But don't forget the sunnah.
When you have toothbrush for this dunya, don't forget the sunnah. Have the miswak for your akhirah.
Follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Bring me a way, a tariqah better than the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I'm bring me any way. And we are ready to accept. 1400 years have passed, and the best way today until Qiyamah is the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah. You know everything loved Rasulullah every single thing loved Rasulullah Hazrat, the wind, the stones, the mountains, everything, the walls, the floor, the sky, the earth, every single thing loved Rasulullah everything Allah Ta'ala created. حضرت مولای قینات مشکل کو شاہ شیرِ خدا حضرت علی المرتضی رضی اللہ تعالی عنہ مولا علی سیدنا علی امیر المؤمنین رضی اللہ تعالی عنہ said we were walking in the streets of Makkah Mukarramah. This was before Ilan Nabuwa, before the age of 40 years old. And Sayyidina Ali said, every single stone and tree we passed by, Allah. Every tree and stone, the Messenger of Allah Almighty passed by, they will not pass by except that every tree and stone would give salam to me. Every tree and stone said, As-salamu as-salamu alayka, ya Rasulullah. Allahu Akbar. Even the stones and trees say, ya Rasulullah. Even the stones and trees say, ya Rasulullah. Even the stones and trees understood Nabi alayhi salam is a Nabi of Allah before Ilan and Nabuwa. Even the stones and trees knew this. And today we have people saying, no, the Prophet wasn't a prophet until 40. No. The real is stones are saying. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, ever since Allah Ta'ala created them, are the first Nabi of Allah. The first Prophet of Allah Almighty. When they were asked, Mata wajaba laka an-nubuwwah ya Rasulullah, when was nubuwwah wajib? When was you given prophethood? They said, kuntu nabiyyan wa adamu bayna ruhi wal jasad. I was a prophet of Allah Almighty when Adam was between body and soul. Hazrat Adam alayhi salam was in between being created, and his body and his soul hadn't come together. Even before Adam alayhi salam's body and soul come together, I was a Nabi of Allah. This hadith is mentioned in the Jami' of Imam Tirmidhi. Imam Tirmidhi rahmatullah alayhi is the student of Imam Bukhari rahmatullah alayhi. And ulama muhaddithun have said that there has never come a great muhaddith than Imam Tirmizi. Some have said that. And his book, Jami Tirmizi, a Jami al-Sahih of Imam Tirmizi, alayhi rahma radiallahu anhu, is regarded more authentic than Bukhari's according to him. It's regarded as more referred to as Sayyidina Imam Bukhari rahmatullah alayhi Sahih Bukhari. This is the rank of Tirmizi. In there, this hadith is mawjood. Rasulullah salam was asked, when was you a prophet? Nabi salam didn't say, Jabir, I was a prophet when I was 40. Jabir, don't you know, I did Ilan and Abu'ud. I announced that I'm a prophet. No. Nabi salam didn't say, Jabir, I don't know when I was a prophet. Nabi salam said, Jabir, I'll tell you how great my ilm is. That I was a prophet of Allah Ta'ala when Adam wasn't even created. Allah prophet went. Those people who say the Prophet ﷺ was born on the top of Rabi al-Awwal, he didn't exist before. This hadith proves Rasulullah ﷺ spiritually existed before Sayyidina Adam ﷺ. So when they say what's the first thing Allah created, we say the nur of the Prophet ﷺ. And they say, well, the Noor Hadith, this is weak, in Mawdu, so and so. But then I ask them, can you deny and reject a Hadith in Jami Tirmidhi? Hadith which is Sahih, which is authentic. Rasulullah said, I was a prophet of Allah, kuntu nabiyyan, wa adamu bayna ruhi wal jasad. When Adam was between body and soul, I was a Nabi of Allah. Yani, even before Adam alayhi salatu was created, I was existing there. Allahu Akbar. I was existing even before Adam alayhi salam was created. Everything loved Rasulullah alayhi salam. And they would walk past stones. Stones would give them salam. Out of love, out of respect, out of honor. Sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Nabi alayhi salatu was salam would stand on the mountain of Uhud. And Uhud would go past. Uhud would go into Badr. Uhud would begin to shake. And you know what Uhud would say to other mountains? Oh mountain, oh Bariyo, oh mountain, look at my Muqaddam, eh? Look at my Muqaddam, look at my kismet. Look at what Allah Ta'ala has given me. That the taj upon my head today.
Allah!
The taj upon my head today are the Na'alayn Sharifayn of Rasulullah. This is why Uhud began to move. And Nabi Salaam to calm Uhud down. They hit their blessed foot on Uhud and said, Uthbut ya Uhud. Uhud, become firm. Thabit rana. Mazboot rana. Become firm, Uhud. You know why? For indeed upon you right now is the Nabi of Allah. Right now is Abu Bakr Siddiq. Right now there is Umar Farooq and Usman. Two martyrs. This mountain of Uhud, Nabi Salatu Salaam used to say, Uhudun Jabalun, Yuhibbuna wa Nuhibbuhu.
Allah, subhanAllah.
Now this mountain, Uhud, what's a mountain? Mountains, pick some stones. You know, people say, why do you pick the stones from the place of Uhud? What does Uhud have? What can this Bata give you, eh? They say, why do you pick these stones and take them home? Oh yeah. Rasulullah Salatu Salaam said, Uhudun Jabal. Uhud is a mountain. Yuhibbuna wa nuhibbuhu. Uhud loves us and we love Uhud. Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Uhud is a mountain. How can a mountain love? How can mountains fall in love? To me and you, mountains are nothing, they just don't. But remember, anything Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed by, they brought it to life. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam brought things to life. Everything Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam passed by untouched. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam instilled life into them. Uhudun jabalun, yuhibbuna wa nuhibbuhu. Uhud is a mountain. Uhud loves us. We love the mountain of Uhud. You know, mahabba, love. Love is an emotion, a quality of the heart. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam is telling me and you that the mountain of Uhud has a heart. And in the heart of the mountain of Uhud is Muhammad al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, you are the mountain of Uhud. On the day of Qiyamah it will be brought forward. And Allah Ta'ala will place it into Jannah al-Firdaus. The mountain of Uhud will be in Jannah. It is from the mountains of Jannah al-Firdaus. Why is it a mountain from the mountains of Jannah al-Firdaus? Because it has the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Loves Nabi. If a mountain gets to Jannah because it loves the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Hazrat, fall in love with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and inshallah we will be in Jannah to fall in love with Nabi sallallahu. Don't claim to love. Don't say, yes bro, I love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Don't put on your Facebook and Twitter, I love the Messenger of Allah. This banner and these Facebook display pictures, no, this doesn't prove your love. This doesn't prove your love. Inna al-muhibba ila al-muhibbi muti. It's the same, or kama qal. That indeed the beloved, inna al-muhibba ila al-muhib, ila al-habib, the beloved to his beloved. When somebody loves someone, what's the first thing he does? He obeys. Muti, ita'at. He's obedient. Allahu Akbar. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran, when he talks about وَمَنْ يُطِعِ الرَّسُولَ فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهُ. Whoever obeys the Prophet of Allah Almighty has obeyed Allah Almighty. Allahu Akbar. Allah Ta'ala, أَتِيُوا اللَّهَ وَأَتِيُوا الرَّسُولَ. Obey Allah and obey the Prophet. Whenever Allah Ta'ala has mentioned his obedience, he has always said, my obedience is my Prophet's obedience. You obey my Prophet and you obey me. Allahu Akbar. Obedience to Rasulullah salatu salam means that we follow his sunnah. We do not miss salah. We keep every fast in Ramadan. We perform hajj once in a lifetime. If Allah has given us the ability, whether it's financial, whether it's physical. We give zakat if Allah Ta'ala has given us the maal and dawlat. We do the zikr of Allah Ta'ala. When Sahabi came to Rasulullah salatu salam and said, Ya Rasulullah, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, I love you. Ya Rasulullah, I love you. Nabiyyi Salatu Wasalam said, companion, what should you say? He said, Ya Rasulullah, wallahi, I love you more than everything. Nabiyyi Salatu Wasalam said, be careful what you say. Don't claim. Don't you say it. Be careful. He said, I swear by Allah, Ya Rasulullah, I love you more than everything. Nabiyyi Salatu Wasalam said, if you truly love me, then prepare to become poor. Prepare to lose everything. For when you love Rasulullah salam, you have to love something, you're going to make sacrifices. And if you love Rasulullah salam, sacrifice your desires. Sacrifice the love of the dunya for the love of Rasulullah salam. Sacrifice what you have for the sake of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And whenever you make a sacrifice for the Nabi salam, always say, Ya Rasulullah, I made this sacrifice to make you happy. Ya Rasulullah, I made this sacrifice to obey you. For your obedience and in honor of you. Allahu Akbar. Whenever you read a naat of Rasulullah salam, always say, Ya Rasulullah, I'm reading this naat in your honor. I'm not reading this naat so that I become famous. Whenever you deliver a talk, always tell yourself, I'm delivering this talk out of honor and love for Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I'm not delivering this so people know who I am. Wallahi, I swear by Allah, if your intention is to please Rasulullah salam, Allah Ta'ala will send the dunya at your feet. You have everything. Izzu man tasha wa tuzillu man tasha. Allah gives izzat to him once and he gives zillat to him. Wallahi, I swear by Allah. If you love Rasulullah salatu salam, Allah Ta'ala not only will give you the izzat of this dunya. Wallahi, in the day of Qiyamah, Allah Ta'ala will give you the izzat of the akhirah. Allah will honor you in the akhirah. But then you have to sacrifice. It's not easy. You gotta start reading your salah. Did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam miss their prayer? Did they forget to do zikr? Never. Rasulullah salam, diamond, all the time, was in the state of remembrance of Allah Almighty. Always in the shukr of Allah Ta'ala. Nabi salatu salam is the best role model for us. لَكَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ وَسْوَةٌ حَسَنًا. No doubt we find the messenger of Allah Almighty the best role model. The best example for all. Till the day of Qiyamah, there will never come an example, a method, or a mithal like Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Mulai Kainat radiallahu anhu said, لَمْ أَرَى قَبْلَهُ وَلَا بَعْدَهُ مِثْلَهُ. I have never seen anyone before him, nor after him, like him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was unique in every aspect, such that everything that was around fell in love with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Everything. Abu Jahl once came to Rasulullah salam, and he said, you tell everyone about what's happening. What will happen till Qiyamah? What's in the heavens, what's on the earth? If you are true Prophet of Allah, if you truly have knowledge of the unseen, then tell me what do I have in my hand. Tell me what's in my hand. Abu Jahl knew Rasulullah salam has ill. Is it? If we settle now, let's not have our own conversations. The lecture is still going on. And then in the house of Allah Ta'ala. When Abu Jahl said this, he said, if you're a true Nabi of Allah, tell me what's in my hand. Nabi alayhi salatu salam said, Ya Abu Jahl. Ya Abu Hakam, tell me. Abu Jahl, tell me. Do you want me to tell you what's in your hand, or do you want what's in your hand to tell you who I am? you what's in your hand? Or do you want what's in your hand to tell you who I am? He said both. Nabi Salatu Salam said, you have six pebbles in your hand. You have six pebbles in your hand. Nabi Salatu Salam said this to Abu Jahl. He opened his hand six. As soon as he opened them, now the pebbles were going to tell Abu Jahl and Rasulullah Salam. And the pebbles began to sing an aunt. They began to read the kalima, La ilaha illallah. And Abu Jahl realized, and he threw them. Everything Rasulullah's nigar fell upon changed. Nabi Salatu Salam changed the state of these pebbles. What's a pebble? What's a pebble? But when the pebble comes in the presence of Rasulullah Salam, they are no ordinary pebbles. You know, the land Rasulullah Salam would walk on, you know, the soil, the blessed soil, the heart of Madina Munawwara. You know how beloved this was to the Sahaba? You know what Hazrat Bilal did when he came to Medina Sharif after he had left? First thing Hazrat Bilal did was got onto their hands and knees. And they picked up the heart of Medina and they rubbed it on their face. Then they walked into Medina. Imam Malik rahmatullah alayh would never wear sandals, slippers, shoes in the city of Medina. No. Why? Because this is where the Prophet would walk. Now love and honor. Tell me the Sahaba who used to touch Rasulullah's water. Nabi Salatu Salam Sahaba, Nabi Salatu Salam is doing wudu. And the wudu, the left of the water that was being used, who touched the Prophet Salam's blessed face and beard. Imagine this, just imagine. Sarvare kono makam, baisa ijabe do alim, rahmatulil alim, shafi'ul muznibin. Habibi Kibriya, Hazrat Muhammad Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is performing wudu. And Sahaba are touching the water which is touching the blessed face of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. This is normal water. But as soon as it has come in contact with Rasulullah Sallam, it has become blessed water. Sahaba began to touch this. And they called it, the Sahaba would rub it on their face. One Sahabi who didn't catch it, he would go to the Sahabi who caught it and said, give me your hand. Let me rub my hand on your hand. Let me rub my hand on your hand. Let me take from your hand the barakah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then he would rub it. Hazrat Bilal said they would fight with one another. Give me your hand, let me rub my hand on your hand. Your hand has the best word of Rasulullah. Nabi Salatu Salam Sahaba, Hazrat Abdullah bin Zubair radiallahu anhu, Sahabi Rasul, drank the blood of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nabi Salatu Salam said, your stomach will never have any illnesses. And the fire of hell will not touch the place that has my blood inside. You know, drinking the blood, catching the water, walking behind Nabi Salam, which ayat of the Quran were they acting upon? You know, everyone says, give me dalil, give me proof, give me proof, give me proof. Give me proof why you do bilal. Prove to me, Quran and Sunnah, why you do it? Did the Sahaba do it? Prove to me where the Sahaba got their proof from to catch the water. Did Allah say in the Quran catches water? Did Allah Ta'ala say in the Quran drink his blood? Did Allah Ta'ala say in the Quran walk behind him? No. Allah Ta'ala did not say none of this, but the Sahaba did it. And when the Sahaba did it, the Nabi Salatu Salam said, don't catch my water. The Nabi Salatu Salam said, not drink my blood. The Nabi Salatu Salam stopped them from expressing their love. Halakha, they're expressing their love without any dalil. Allahu Akbar. Nabi Salam never stopped them. Allah Ta'ala didn't even reveal a verse in the Quran to stop them. Hazrat, the actions of the Sahaba are the dalil for me and you to do the milad of Rasulullah. If the Sahaba Ridwanullahi Ta'ala alayhim ajma'een didn't need a dalil, a proof from Quran or Sunnah to catch the water and drink the blood, and the dalil that they had, the understanding was out of love, out of honor, out of respect. We catch your water, we drink your blood, we walk behind you, we take barakah from out of love, honor and respect. that if this is the reason for why the Sahaba did what they did, then our reason is the very same reason as those Sahaba, that today we gather to remember the Milad of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And remember, the actions of the Sahaba become a dalil for people like me and you. We follow what the Sahaba did. And if they said, did the Sahaba do Milad? Alam, Rasulullah alayhi salam, Sahaba were always happy with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Sahaba were always expressing shukr. Azrat, we are on haq. What we are doing is correct. Don't let nobody tell you otherwise. And if they do, send them to me. This is our job. This is our responsibility. Send them to Mawlana Zawuti Shkisha. Send them to the ulama. And tell them, go speak to our scholars. Go speak to our imams. Ask them, they will give you the dalal. Hazrat, love Rasulullah alayhi salam. Honor him, respect him. And you know when we take this from? Love, honor, respect. This is in the Quran. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran says, لِتُؤْمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَتُعَذِّرُوهُ وَتُوَقِّرُوهُ. And believe in Allah is Rasul. And honor him. And respect. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We honor and respect every single thing about the Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam. And make dua to Allah Ta'ala that Allah gives us all tawfiq to continue to express our happiness at the arrival of the Prophet into this world. And we express our honor and our respect for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah forgive me if I've said anything wrong or wrong is to me. All good is from Allah and His Habib, Sayyidina Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and dua on my parents and my teachers. Wa akulu qawli hadha, astaghfirullah li wa lakum, wa akhiru da'wana, alhamdulillah.